special, ladies and gentlemen, it is official. Matt Kenseth will return to the Monster Energy NASCAR Cup Series in 2018. So Matt announced that he will be running a partial schedule in the sixth car and is going to share that ride with current driver Trevor Bayne. Matt began his Cup Series career with Jack Ryan back in 1998. 20 years later, he is welcomed home with open arms. A family affair. As you can see, the entire family was out there celebrating this day with Matt.
Here's Alan Cavana. Adam, a pleasant surprise to many. Matt Kenseth back in the Cup Series. It was a surprise to many, even in your own shop, that you were coming back. Are you surprised you're going to be back with Roush Fenway Racing?
Well, a little bit. I'm excited to be back. It's a really unique opportunity for me. It's a challenge that I'm actually really looking forward to. It's really cool to come back. It's kind of where it all started. Obviously, Jack and Mark have meant a lot to me and in my career. And I'm looking forward to coming back here and trying to help Jack and trying to get things going better.
If you're in the car, that means Trevor Bayne is not. You know that feeling of maybe being not behind the driver's seat with circumstances beyond your control. What will you say to Trevor?
Well, I'm looking forward to having a conversation with Trevor. I mean, we've all been around the sport for a long time. We know that driver changes don't really have anything to do with drivers. It doesn't really have anything to me that he's going to be out of the car. But with that being said, see where his head's at. I'm looking forward to working with him and Ricky. And like I said, I'm hoping I can help. I'm looking forward to that. I'm sure he's disappointed not being in the car all the time, but Trevor's a great person. You can't meet a better guy than Trevor Bayne. He's very competitive, good race car driver. So looking forward to meeting with him hopefully next week.
All right. Well, Matt Kenseth, welcome back to the Cup Series. They haven't announced his full schedule yet, but we'll see him in Kansas and the All-Star Race.
Alan, one thing we know for sure, Matt has had some great moments when driving for the Roush Fenway organization. Let's go back to 2009 when he hoisted the first of his two Harley J. Earl trophies. Who was his crew chief on that Sunday evening in Daytona?
Some much younger guy.
Oh. Right here. 2009, the best start to any of his 18 seasons, because 1 week after winning the Daytona 500, Drew and Matt went back to Victory Lane at California Auto Club Speedway. Just two wins, part of a milestone career.
A rookie has won the Coca-Cola 600. Matt Kenseth has done it. Matt Kenseth wins the biggest race of them all.
Kenseth wins the Daytona 500.
Here's the checkers.
Still, it's not like he's been sitting out for a long time. Matt's a winner, and I think it's something that Roush, possibly Ford, and possibly sponsors on the six car needed to see to evaluate the program over there on the six.
And I think, maybe it's somewhat process of elimination, but I think it's also, bringing in just some fresh blood and some new ideas, right? He's coming from a great race team at Joe Gibbs Racing. Maybe the way their processes of how they build a great race car is different than Roush. Good and bad, who knows? But it just brings in a fresh perspective, I think, that they didn't have before. So it's just something different, something new. I'm sure he's going to bring a lot to the table. He's a very experienced race car driver that's been through a lot. So it'll be interesting to see how it goes moving forward and maybe, answer some of the questions that Roush Racing has right now.
Let's face it, this is not a big surprise. He never said, I'm retiring. He did win, as Drew said, 11 races to go. But why Roush Fenway and why now? The timing of this is very interesting.
Well, I think probably Matt and Mark are probably still very close. Mark helped Matt get his start over at Roush Fenway. Mark is still invested into Roush Fenway, trying to help them out. And it looks like they needed a sponsor as well. and a sponsor and a guy who won 11 races ago, that kind of helps put everything together, so it kind of just fits. Matt's physically probably in the best shape he has, and everybody was surprised he was sitting on the couch this year.
You know, I think one person that hasn't really come up is Trevor Bayne, right? What kind of position does this put Trevor Bayne in when you know someone else is jumping in your car?
I don't think there's a tougher position to be in this sport than this spot that Trevor Bayne's in right now. You know, he's obviously been digging at this for a long time, you know, and you never want to see the name on top of that car change, especially when it's not your idea, right? Yeah. So, you know, it'll be interesting to see how this plays out, because what's the next step, right? If Matt gets in this thing and he does run well, is it now Matt's ride? Or is it handed back to Trevor with some new information? Well, what's going to happen? I think that's the big question when we see what happens at the end of the year here. Because who knows, right? I mean, Matt may run the same as Trevor. He may run better. He may run worse. We'll just have to wait and see how that goes.
The one goal, though, for every team is to make the playoffs. I mean, that's kind of the baseline for success when you look at top organizations in NASCAR. I'm not saying they're giving up on that with a 16, but if Trevor doesn't win at Talladega or Dover, and given the way they run, Dover's going to be a bit of a long shot. They're not going to make the playoffs because Trevor's not going to qualify, and Matt certainly won't because he's missed some races. How do you feel about that part of it? And what's that say about the situation, Drew?
Well, I think it says Roush has done just that. They said we're back 25th, 26th in points with Trevor. They obviously needed some sponsorship sold on the race car just to continue throughout the rest of the year. So I think this is a good part of the season for them to get somebody in there. It's not too late to turn it around. If Matt comes in with some information and runs better, it'll help the 17. So I think this helps the whole organization, and they need to do it sooner than later.
Andy Petrie yesterday said that he thinks that the Matt Kenseth factor is 10 positions better than what that car is currently running. Is that a high side or a low side number?
I think that's exactly what I would say as well. Matt Kenseth expects to run in the top 10, and that car hasn't done that recently. And he's good enough to run in the top 10, so I expect it to run up front.
But if Matt Kenseth brings Wyndham, and then he runs 10 positions better than what Trevor has, the sponsors will continue to come, right? He'll make believers out of a lot of people.
Absolutely. All right, let's shift our focus to the three guys.